tips receh berfaedah. Kembali lagi, peraturan baru pada platform YouTube di 2019 yang akan diterapkan di 10 Desember nanti. COPPA atau COPPA dari FTA, Federal Trade Commission, US, harus dipatuhi oleh para kreator. Lalu apakah COPPA dan FTA itu? Saksikan dulu sekilas berikut ini. Tentu akan sangat berpengaruh sekali untuk sebagian kreator dan sebagian channel-channel yang berkaitan dengan peraturan baru ini nantinya. COPPA itu sendiri adalah singkatan dari informasi berikut ini akan menjelaskannya.
COPPA stands for the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act, which is a federal law that restricts the ability of website operators to collect personal information about children under the age of 13. COPPA applies anytime a website operator seeks to collect or use personal information of children under the age of 13. COPPA defines personal information very broadly. A student's name, email address, photograph, telephone number, mailing address, audio and video files that feature the child, and a persistent identifier that can be used to recognize a user over time and across different websites or online services, such as a screen or username that functions as online contact information, are all considered personal information. Under COPPA, these websites must provide parental notification and obtain verifiable parental consent before collecting personal information from children under the age of 13.
As educators, we are responsible for the educational, physical, emotional, and mental well-being of our students. We are hired to protect them while they are under our care. For most of us, and ideally for all of us, we will do anything to educate and protect them. Federal law mandates that all teachers and administrators follow the Children's Online Privacy Protection Act. This is commonly called the COPPA or COPPA law. The COPPA law applies to all students who are under the age of 13. In a nutshell, the law applies to digital publication of any personal information about these students. Digital publication includes, but is not limited to, information shared via the internet, emails, social media accounts, text messages, third-party vendors, games, blogs, CDs, thumb drives, cloud accounts, and videos. Digital publication possibilities are being created every day, so it is virtually impossible to list them all here. This means that before any student's photo or inclusion in any video, there must be written approval from the student's guardian in order to be digitally published. This permission is given by the guardian when the student is enrolled through the online registration process. Also, a student cannot be personally identified in a digital publication. This includes the student's name, address, specific location, contact information, phone number, email address, social security number, and parent names and addresses. Even with a guardian's permission, this information cannot be digitally published. It is important for all educators to be aware that student information cannot be shared with a third-party vendor without specific school district approval and guardian approval. This means that a teacher cannot subscribe to a district non-approved site or service where student names or photos are published. This also means that student emails cannot be used to create accounts with non-approved third-party vendors. Please contact Jim if you have any questions about this. There is always the possibility that an educator does not want to follow COPPA law. If this is the case, the educator is breaking the law and is subject to all penalties. This means that once an inquiry is begun, the educator is responsible for all court costs and lawyer costs. If the educator is found guilty of violating COPPA law, the maximum penalty is $40,000 per violation, along with the possible loss of the educator's license. Now, that's the negative information. Sorry that it needed to be such a downer. So let's talk about what you can do in regards to sharing student information. You are more than welcome to use student photos and names inside your classroom. You can use student photos with name associations, videos, and student first and last names for internal school district use. You just need to make sure the information is not publicly shared through digital publications. Also, if you have a third-party vendor in mind, simply ask Jim if you can have permission to use the vendor. If approved, then you will be able to use the site or service following any guidelines shared with you. It is your responsibility as an educator to ensure that you follow all COPPA guidelines to ensure the safety of your students. It isn't difficult to do, but does require effort. Thank you for your time and your assistance with this important law.
Untuk sebagian besar channel tidak usah khawatir. Caranya mudah untuk menghadapi ini dan harus siap. Seperti melakukan sedikit perubahan dan penyetingan di YouTube Studio. Check it out.
Kita bisa melakukan penyetingan melalui YouTube Studio ataupun Creator Studio ataupun YouTube Studio Beta. Intinya adalah bagaimana kita memberitahu bahwa video yang kita buat di YouTube tidak diperuntukkan untuk anak-anak atau memang sengaja dibuat untuk anak-anak. Inilah yang harus kita tegaskan dan berikan informasi kepada penonton. Jadi, jika memang video kamu tidak dibuat untuk anak-anak, pilih saja option tidak dibuat untuk anak-anak. Hal ini sebagai kreator seperti yang sudah dijelaskan pada informasi sebelumnya, juga sebagai edukator ataupun teladan kepada anak-anak dan melindungi privasi terhadap anak-anak di bawah umur. Meskipun regulasi ataupun hukum ini memang adanya di negara asalnya, United States, kita tetap harus mengikuti peraturannya karena kita berada di dalam platform YouTube itu sendiri. Jadi mau tidak mau kita harus siap dan menjalankan peraturan yang sudah ataupun akan ditetapkan oleh YouTube. Sehingga kita sebagai edukator ataupun kreator juga bisa memberikan kontribusi kepada anak-anak di bawah umur pada khususnya. Di channel saya sendiri juga memiliki segmen tentang game, yaitu tentang game Naruto. Tetapi saya akan setting melalui setelan lanjutan dan pilih tidak. Video ini tidak dibuat untuk anak-anak, karena saya juga ingin memberikan edukasi dan tahu diri bahwa memang channel saya tidak diperuntukkan khusus untuk anak-anak. Untuk kalian yang memiliki konten ataupun channel khusus anak-anak, segeralah dengan bijak untuk menerapkan aturan ini. Caranya mudah dan ikuti saja.
Tips receh berfaedah, semoga bermanfaat dan memberikan sedikit gambaran tentang apa itu dan persiapan kita terhadap peraturan baru YouTube 2019 yang akan dimulai Desember nanti. Dan semoga terus berkarya dengan optimis para kreator. Tetap semangat, yang belum dimonetisasi, jangan patah semangat. Semoga dalam waktu cepat ini segera dimonetisasi. See you on next video. Ivan Van Nixon dari Kali Ciliwung, Pangkalan Camat Gabun, melaporkan.